All right, this is the Crowded House Machine with Kelly Minnell. We thought that Kelly was out of the top five, but because Conrad White, the rookie, is on a day license, Kelly Minnell progressed into that top five. So do apologise for that misinformation that was provided to you by me. And I'm trying to look around and see who I can blame for that. So, Kelly Minnell, Nicky Ferguson, Crowded House. So, still, Kelly just hasn't been able to get these hairpins lined up. How's she going to go here? Last time out, she was quite good through here. And that time again, just seems to lose it up in here in the Mouth Fresh Island up the top. Nailed it. Absolutely nailed it. So Kelly Minnell and Nicky Ferguson now down the back chute, looking, searching, reaching for that line, and a 63.187. So Kelly Minnell, that is her quickest time by 1.4 seconds. So good time of the day to be doing that. So, yes, we actually have a top six in the Group B. Conrad White, our rookie, is not in the national championship. He's running on a day licence. So the way that our organisers have decided over the course of a number of years is that a day licence can't bump somebody out of the overall championship, and this is the same deal that he's run right around the world. So very positive move by the the executive committee, as they like to be known. So it will be Buttercup and the Cookie, Daniel Reed and Andrew Bakey. So the time that they came in here with was a 62.049. They want to bring it right down into the low 60s. Do they have the ability to bring it down another 2 seconds? Buttercup, just get it smooth around the first corner. Yes, he did that. Put that one behind you now. Into this part of the track, very smooth through there as well. So Buttercup seems to be down a little bit on the horsepower. Little tiny little bit knifey in there, but he's not going to worry about that. This is a very good smooth drive at the moment for Daniel Reed and Andrew Bakey in the Aqua Holly. No! Buttercup has beached it. So that is the end of the day for Buttercup. So interestingly, this will put Kelly Minnell in a pretty good position to be able to get on the podium for the overall championship for the 2007 series in the Crowded Houseboat. So still plenty of twists and turns in this epic tale of the 2017 Altherm Window Systems Jet Sprint Series. And, the final page, the final chapter has yet to be written.
Well, as they say, she's never over till it's over, and they've proven that today.
Yeah, absolutely. So the pressure really telling, and we're talking some very experienced racers making some rookie mistakes, and yet the rookies not making mistakes.
Well, they're calm and collected and just keep going, aren't they?
It's just unbelievable. So our next boat to face the starter will be one of those rookies in Conrad White. And I'll tell you what, if this bloke gets onto the podium today, I dare say that we'll make it his shout, eh?
Well, why not?
Yeah, right, good idea.
Sounds good. Even if he doesn't.
Yeah, actually, good idea. We're on to it.
Yep.
So, Conrad White with James Reed The boys from the motocross background, the boat is the Whiplash, the Loyal Fishing, and All Red Fuel, the sponsors on board here. So Conrad White in this very, very old hull, doing a wonderful, wonderful job. Oh, big bang! Walla walla, bing bang! That is, oh, that is absolutely massive, and that is upside down in a big way. So the safety crew straight over there, both driver and navigator out, and okay, ladies and gentlemen, give them a big round of applause. Oh, that is going to take some time to put the boat back on its feet and come back. So we'll take a short break. And wow, we were talking the rookies up and the rookies blew it. Yeah, very, very disappointing end of the day. Well, that's what racing's about. We'll be back soon. James Reed, the boys from the motocross background, the boat is the Whiplash, the Loyal Fishing, and All Red Fuel, the sponsors on board here. So Conrad White in this very, very old hull, doing a wonderful, wonderful job.
Yeah, we best give them a big round of applause, please.
Well, quite like the boys giving the big thumbs up to the crowd there. Typical young fellas just loving the fact that they've just won Crash of the Day so far. They should be very happy with that at the moment. They acquitted themselves beautifully. We talked them up, and then they crashed. But they, so far, that is the most spectacular crash of the day. So pretty good.
We are not used to doing things by halves, is it?
No, that's right. So our next boat to face the starter will be the team of Schizo. Patrick Hayden will be your helmsman. His wife, Jay Hayden, will be doing the navigational duties. Patrick Hayden is 1 point ahead of the championship of Clayton and Mandy Tisdall. And at the moment, Clayton Tisdall is 1.5 seconds quicker than the next boat we're going to face, that it's going to face the starter. So very interesting times here. So the time that Paddy Hayden wants to beat is the time that Crowded House set of a 63. So Paddy and Jay Hayden now. The boat is Schizo. This boat just doesn't seem to have the power throughout the course of the day what we normally see from it. Certainly looking a lot better and a lot quicker this time out, but just not too sure that when I was talking to Paddy during the lunch break that he was giving me the full information of what was going on with the boat.
Yeah, well, you can't give too much away in this game, can you?
No, you can't at all, because I'll tell you the interesting thing about this sport is that the blokes will share boats, they'll share information, that you know, but they won't share a secret, I'll tell you. They are unbelievable. But Paddy Hayden around that mouth pressure island at the top part of the track quite nicely indeed. Now lining it up for the centre, up to the top in the latter part of this lap. The split was sort of near where he wants to be, but he's going to have to get a hurry up. He will definitely beat the time that Kelly Minnell posted. So Paddy Hayden, Schizo, 59.646. So that is his best time of the day by 1.6 seconds. So coming right at the right time of the day. So he'll be happy with that run. That means that at the moment, it is Kelly Minnell who will be sitting on the bubble with Tim Edhouse and Clayton Tisdall yet to run. So Tim Edhouse, liquid addiction. We've seen this boat throughout the course of the day not handling well, being an absolute pig around some of the corners, and just haven't quite had that setup sorted out. Tim Edhouse sitting currently in equal fourth on the championship. So he needs to beat Kelly Minnell, but he needs to gain a further 8 points on her. So don't know that that's going to happen.
No, I don't think it can it?
Yeah, my calculations.
We're going to have to do this Edden thing again, aren't we?
Oh, no.
Who's
no.
Who's got the abacus?
No, because we've got the secretary and the genius boy over here are going to help us.
Oh, that's good.
Yep. The worst that Kelly can do is third in the championships. Wow, so she will be wrapped with that with the, with her rookie drive, rookie season.
Are we going to go down this road again?
No, because she's not, well, we can because she's not on the track at the moment. Wait till she comes out again and then we can go down the track and see what happens. But at first it will be Liquid Addiction, Tim Edhouse, Blair Edhouse. So these guys really on fire at the moment. Oh, a bit of a hiccup. Got the boat bogged down. He's done that a couple of times around there. This competition is tighter than Leighton Minnell's undies. From what I've heard. So, the big back off into that left hander. Yeah, the boat just... not handling at all like we normally see this particular vessel handle. But again, we're talking about high altitude and low density water as well. So that certainly makes big changes to the setup of the boats. Traditionally, the boats can run in sort of murky, muddy sort of water. Gives it a lot more buoyancy. This water fresher, cleaner. And a 61.046. So Tim Edhouse into P2. And 1.6 seconds slower than the time that Paddy Hayden set. So, Clayton Tisdall the run. Kelly Minnell still sitting on the bubble. Clayton Tisdall and Mandy Tisdall get inside of two. The locals, well, from Tapa Nui, which is 3 hours away or something, 2.5 hours away.
That's more than local in Australia terms.
Well, it is. That's just around the corner.
That's
literally, like you'd go that far to get a pint of milk.
That's
if you
right.
drank milk. right. Now, this is Clayton and Mandy haven't found themselves in this position before. So if they can keep a clear, smart head about them, they will progress into the top three, and then it'll be a runoff for the championship with Paddy Hayden, who is already progressing into the top three. I wonder how this couple have really thought about this. Are they just trying to put all that behind them, not overthink it, just go through the processes that they know they've got to do?
Well, we can only hope they're not overthinking it and just got the mind on this lap.
Yeah, well, that's it. And, look, you know, I'm not too sure that, Clayton might not be able to think too much, I wouldn't have thought.
He's only got to think for a minute.
Yeah, that's right. It's only 1 minute of concentration at this point. So this jet speed hull really looking very, very smooth and fast as well. Not getting the bounce out of the boat that we see with the two stinger hulls with Tim Edhouse and Paddy Hayden. So this boat just sitting very nicely. I'll tell you what, Mandy Tisdall, for a very short lady, has a very long arm with that navigational pointing.
He's got no excuse not to know where he's going.
Yeah, that's a very nice hairpin there. So up into the mouth fresh roundabout now. Oh, very nice through there. Really keeping a very good close eye. Oh, yes, Mandy just said, right, she's very, very animated, very, very switched on here. So Clayton Tisdall, the sails are wet. It's going to be a good time, 58.858. So Clayton Tisdall has gone quick time for the Group Bs and is 0.8 seconds quicker than Paddy Hayden. So it's going to look like this for the top three of the Group B. Tim Edhouse, Patrick Hayden, Clayton Tisdall. It's going to come down to the final run in the Group B to determine the New Zealand Championship of 2017. How many butterflies do you think are in the pits at the moment?
Oh, well, she's just nail-biting, isn't it?
I'll tell you what, that is just sensational. We are going to reset and get ready